Pato from IndyCar, everybody. This is episode 2 of Exotics with Ava.
Pato Ward, the future of IndyCar right here.
One of the most exciting talents on the scene right now.
Who looks good? Jumping out of line is Pato Ward. There's Rosen with the blue and orange car.
Look at Ward. Look at Ward on the high side in the PJ1.
Look out. Here comes Pato Ward.
Hi guys, it's Ava. We're here for the second episode of Exotics with Ava. I have IndyCar racer Pato here with me, and we have just a couple of questions that we're going to ask him. So how are you?
I'm good. How are you guys? Thank you for having me.
Good. I'm glad that you're here with us. I just have a few questions that I wanted to ask you.
Okay.
So my first one is, if you could tell your younger self anything, what would it be?
Time goes by fast, so I'd probably have to go with try and live in the moment as much as you can, because it goes by a lot faster than what you feel like or than what you think.
So definitely like take advantage of your moments.
Yeah, just like enjoy what like you in the now is doing. Like everything that you're doing at that time should be the most important thing that you're doing. Don't think too far ahead or what has happened in the past. Like learn how to turn the page quickly and then just learn how to move forward and enjoy the process of it. Don't get too ahead of yourself and be like, you're not in a good mood if you're not there, or just truly enjoy where you're at.
Oh, I love that answer. I really feel like everybody just needs to like kind of sit back and turn off their phone sometimes and just really enjoy life. So I think that's an amazing answer. I think there are a lot of kids, or like, you know, there's really a lot of youth that are getting into like NASCAR and F1 and Indy and just racing in general and just getting into the car game. And I feel like you could be possibly a really big inspiration for a lot of our youth out there. What would you give our youth as a piece of advice, you know, from you to just them on becoming successful in, you know, racing and everything?
Honestly, I consider myself lucky in being able to find something that I love and adore doing. And I'm lucky enough to be able to do it as a career now. But if you love something, no one can take that away from you. They can tell you, oh, you're dreaming, oh, you're... But you're the only one that can control the outcome of, do you want to try it? What do you want to do with that? So I feel like the best thing that I can tell you is, if you love something, and especially if you're good at it, don't stop doing it. Find every way you can to continue doing it, because things will fall into their place and you will get your chance.
Yeah, I totally agree. I think that if you love something, you should just never give up, you know, just keep going forward. If you could go back into time and you could see your little baby self, what would you tell baby you?
Baby me, I would tell him, enjoy the process, enjoy the journey, and don't doubt yourself. Because in a lot of times, whether you've proven it many times, I am, and many other athletes are in a sport or in a profession where you need to continue proving in order to kind of like keep earning your place where you are. And sometimes it's very easy to kind of fall back and have like a little misstep and feel like, you know, do I still have it? Do I still, you know, am I still good enough? So I'd probably say just don't doubt yourself. You don't all of a sudden run out of talent if you have talent. There's no reason why you should start doubting yourself, but it's very easy to do, and I have for sure done it, and I'm still in the process of it. I still suffer from that sometimes. It's not like everything is, you know, rainbows and unicorns and smiley faces. Everything is it takes time and it takes a lot of work.
That's a really good answer. Yeah. So do you feel like you were like very doubtful, like in your past? Is that why you say that, or?
Not always, but there were certain times where it wasn't as smooth, you know, whether it's like you're racing in a different country with a different team, with a different series, you don't know the tracks, you don't know anybody, and you can feel a little bit out of place, or you can feel like, can I do it? Because you get to a point where in the levels of now is everyone's good. So you have to be the one that's better than all of
better
them.
Better than
but
the
being
best.
Better than the best is what's really hard. So at times you obviously are like, you know, like what's going on? And to be fairly honest, it's kind of like what I've experienced these past couple months. We just started our season and it hasn't really gone our way. But we're all trying to stay positive and confident, like, you know, things will fall into place and just keep doing what we've been learning all, you know, all our life. Because sometimes it's so easy to, like, just forget all of that you've learned and then, like, panic.
Right.
You know?
Yeah. Yeah. So I just have a few more questions. The next one would be, what kept you motivated and what kept you going, like, through everything, you know, through all of your years and just through all the times that you maybe didn't get the win that you wanted to, or, you know, you might have had doubts of yourself and everything. What kept you motivated and what kind of kept you going through those times?
That's a great question. Well, first, I love to win. And everything I've always done, whether it's racing or anything else, I've always done it to win. I guess I do it for the kid that fell in love with racing. Like, it's just you do it for, like, I'm here because of that dream, right? So I feel like that dream is what keeps driving you for the rest of your career. It's just, that's what keeps you going, I guess.
And then you said something about kind of going up against the best of the best. So once you kind of get in that position that you're there and you're with everyone that also fought so hard to be there, and they are the best of the best, and you're also one of the best of the best, what kind of, like, you know, makes you be like, come out of your shell and, you know, kind of just like give your best? Does it put you more in a doubtful mindset, like, when you go up against the best of the best? Or are you like, I'm here to kill it, I'm here to fuck it up, I'm here to, like, kind of prove my name and show my name, you know? Is it, which way is it for you?
I think that's when, like, that kind of competitive side, like, never sets away. And it's like, what I've always told everybody, whether you maybe not believe it as much or you do, every single weekend or every single championship or wherever you may be, everywhere you go, you have to walk in there and know that you can kick everyone's ass.
That you can win.
Because if you don't believe that, then you're not gonna win.
Right, right, yeah. You can't have who any knows doubt if you can in your
or,
mind.
Yeah, yeah, who knows if you can or if you can't. But you need to walk in there with just the biggest pile of confidence that you can, and you need to know that you can beat them.
Yeah, and I feel like, if you have confidence, then that kind of puts everybody else, they're like, oh shit, like, he's confident. Like, you know, it kind of, like, puts doubt in them a little bit.
It's bigger whenever you make it to, like, the big star categories. Because, for example, for me, I'm racing now with guys that I've been watching since I was a kid racing.
Right.
So you are racing against the guys that you're like, oh my God.
Your idols. Like, you are going up against your idols.
And you have to walk in there and you have to be like, I'm going to beat you.
I'm going
to
kick your ass. Yeah. So that's crazy. I mean, it has to be like an exhilarating feeling.
It's hard to
feeling.
Do. It's hard to, like, to truly be like, I can do it. But once you do it once,
you can, you know, you're done. You know, you're good. It's kind of like when you dip your toe in the water and then you just jump in, right?
Exactly.
Okay. Awesome. Well, thank you so much for,
you.
Coming and just answering our few questions. I really appreciate you. Pato from IndyCar, everybody. Make sure you guys give him a follow. This is episode 2 of Exotics with Ava. Can you show them a little bit what you got going on in there?
Yeah, so I've wanted to do this for so long. And I only wanted to do it with the best, of course. Stars in the ceiling here in Los Angeles, California. I think it looks spectacular. It looks awesome. Awesome, awesome. And I'm so happy that I kind of, like, found the time to be able to do it, because I've always wanted to do it, but I was like, man, I live very far from California. How am I gonna get it there? And I say, you know what? Let's sort it out. Let's get it there. And it works out, because this weekend we're racing in Long Beach, so it's good that I can use it here a couple of days before I leave. And we got some checkered flag
some
stripes.
Racing stripes, I see. Those are pretty cool.
And they're from half to the back, so the front of the car has actually already crossed the checkered flag, which I feel like I feel like a resemblance with, because my whole life I've been racing checkered flags and stopwatches. So I think it fits well.
Absolutely, I agree. Make sure you guys subscribe. Hit that subscribe button, hit that like button. We have Pato here.
Thank you, everyone.